In this video, you will witness me creating a complete Death Star from scratch. Starting with a single block, I will build the whole thing, and that without using any mods. And since that might be a bit boring on its own, in the end I'm actually going to add a working laser cannon to the Death Star, using only the magic of command blocks. Hello, beautiful people of the internet. In this video, I can only use the creative mode and Minecraft commands to create the Death Star. So, let's see how I did. First, I started with the reactor core, which is in the center of the Death Star. I naturally also did my architectural duties and looked up some build plans for Death Stars on Google. To my surprise, I actually found a pretty good one, which I put a link to in the video description if you're interested. Though I still need to make a few changes to make the build plan fit better into the Minecraft environment. The final Death Star will still be roughly faithful to the build plan, for the most part, but there will be some small changes. After I finished with the reactor core, I continued upwards and built the main power generator. It would be responsible for actually converting the forces in the reactor core to usable energy in a Death Star. On it sit the power processing networks and the tractor beam generating towers. Tractor beams would be the nice little gravitational forces with which to catch and pull those pesky evil rebel ships into the hangar base for our brave intergalactic soldiers to arrest. After the top structure was done, I could use it as a benchmark on how high the final Death Star should be. Then I needed to build a structure of the same height at the bottom of the reactor core. I built a big tank for the water outflow from the reactor core below it, and naturally I also needed a filtering machine and a pump to get water flow back into the reactor core. At this moment I also decided to add some lights to the whole structure so everyone watching this video could actually see what I am doing. The next thing I added was the central computer core responsible for controlling most of the infrastructure, especially the reactor. Below, there needed to be a heat exchanger so that the mechanics don't fry themselves. I also added some stellar fuel bottles for good measure and a cooling system at the bottom. What was now missing was a place where the Death Star could actually store all the energy produced by the generator. So I added three little neat power cells hanging from a ring right above the central computer core. What is the most important thing for a proper Death Star? Naturally, it's not the reactor core, which is only there for the hero to blow up at the end of the movie. No, it's the super laser, the most destructive force of any evil intergalactic empire. So I started building the basic structure for that. At first I needed to know how long this thing should actually be, which was a bit annoying since the cannon is not horizontal to the core and I needed to keep the outer shell of the Death Star in mind, which I needed to build later. So I used a quick Minecraft command to place a block in a distance of 105 blocks away from the core at an angle of about 45 degrees. And then I placed some more blocks and had a line of blocks by which I could orient myself. I added an iron structure around it, which would be the support structure for the primary power amplifier of the super laser. It would go from the reactor core all the way to the outer shell. Later I would then hang the actual super laser cannon below it. Now that I had the total size of the Death Star defined by these basic structures, it was time to create a shell around it. Creating this outer shell by hand would be ridiculous and take ages to complete. So instead I used command blocks to automate the process. The general concept behind it is pretty simple. I spawned an armor stand in the middle of the Death Star. I teleported it to look upwards and then slowly rotated it downwards. Then I could use special Minecraft coordinates to target a point that is a certain distance away relative to where the armor stand was looking. With this, I could easily generate a half circle around the armor stand, like is shown with the particles here. But instead of particles, I needed to do it with blocks, so I let the armor stand place a concrete block around 100 blocks away from where it was looking. Then I slowly rotated the armor stand around using command blocks. This resulted in a nice half circle. Now I just needed to repeat this process to create a complete outer shell. The best thing about this process is that it should produce the optimal sphere possible in Minecraft. It's also faster than doing it by hand, but as I had to find out, not by much. As I couldn't wait for a day for it to finish, I added 3 additional armor stands to speed it up. Then I decided to add another 4 more to bring the total up to 8 armor stands. Like this, the total process for generating the sphere still took around 2 hours. And the final outer shell was roughly 210 blocks high and wide. Now it was time to add some patterns to the shell using Minecraft fill commands. I also discovered that using black concrete for the shell might not have been the best color choice, so I decided to switch to a combination of gray glazed terracotta and gray concrete instead. Adding patterns to the whole sphere took a few hours, but after that I could finally begin creating the actual round disc for the super laser on the outer shell. I manually measured a distance of 2x10 blocks in each direction and created an outline using redstone blocks. I started with the inner part of the round disc first, then I cleared the outer part and finished the round disc. I also added some patterns on the top of the Death Star, which had previously been empty. Now it was time to add the actual cannon construction to the inside. As the build plan I found was much too complicated regarding this, I opted to create my own design. I added 2 energy rings around the center of the round disc, and in the middle I put this laser module, which would convert the energy from the generator to the actual laser beam. I also added some more lights to the whole inner structure, since it was still a little too dark in some parts. As a finishing touch for the cannon, I also added a power cell on top of the support structure. Now I stood before a big problem. I had to fill up this gigantic empty shell with more stuff, since a proper Death Star certainly is made of more than just a poor little iron pillar in the middle. That's why I decided to make an inner wall running right through the middle of the Death Star. With a wall like this, I would have something proper to attach the next structures to, and I would also have a great excuse to ignore everything behind the wall. So I began creating the wall's outline, then I filled in the smaller areas. For the other areas I used Minecraft fill commands to fill in rectangular areas of blocks. After the walls were finished, I continued by adding structures to the left side. I started out with the main hyperdrive going directly from the reactor core to the outer shell. It would be used by a real Death Star to move around. Below I built some small round water tanks which would be responsible for processing most of the daily water usage of the machines, especially of those on the left side of the wall. I also added a neat little water pump. I directly attached the pump to an atmosphere processing unit which would be responsible for creating an artificial atmosphere inside the Death Star. Then I built an ion drive reactor and connected it to the unit, as well as another atmosphere processing unit that I copied on top of it using a Minecraft clone command. After that I added a computer cluster. It would control most of the functions in the sector of the Death Star, including the atmosphere processing units. And a little below on the right I created some big stationary water tanks that would be responsible for storing water more permanently. And that was pretty much it for the left side, besides some other very, very small additions. Next it was time for the right side. I added 2 smaller hyperdrives there as well to make steering the Death Star easier. I also built some tanks which would supply the sector with water. Below I added some honeycomb-like structures which would be the main living quarters for the workers and troopers on the Death Star. I also added a water filtering unit. You can't just provide the Intergalactic Empire's best troops with dirty toilet water after all. Besides the power cells, a good Death Star also needs a long-term storage battery for storing excess energy. And also some utter random tech. And with this, the internal structure of the Death Star was finally done. It was time to make the Death Star actually work. That meant it was my favorite time of the day. Command block time. I saw a method of using the particle beams between end crystals and an enter tracking to simulate the super laser, but I decided against that. Instead, I decided to go with a normal particle effect using Minecraft particle commands. After some searching, I decided to go with the sneeze particle effect. Yes, sneeze. The glorious particle effect of baby panda sneezing. Yes, I use it because it's green, what's wrong with that? And looking at it, nobody can even tell that their planet was destroyed by a beam of snot instead of a laser beam, so who cares? I have 8 locations around the round disk from which laser beams will be targeted towards a single center point. I generate these particle beams using 5 particle commands for each beam with repeating command blocks. The particle beams are slightly placed apart from each other, so to create a bigger and denser beam than a single particle command could. I did that for each of the 8 beams and voila, the first prototype of the firing animation was done. But I couldn't just leave those command blocks sitting on the outer shell, so I decided to build a platform on the inside of the Death Star. On this platform I would then place all the redstone and command block stuff required for the super laser to work. At first I constructed a simple system with an on and off state that could be toggled with the simple flick of a lever. Then I moved the command blocks from outside the shell inside and onto the platform. Now we had a nice little particle animation, but it was still a bit boring in my opinion. That's why I decided to create another animation that would play before the laser beams appear, and which would include those 2 rings of the inner cannon structure. I wanted to have these 2 rings slowly turn green like a loading symbol, for example, one after the other when switching the super laser on. I recorded all the block coordinates by hand into command blocks. Those command blocks would then fill in these rings with emerald blocks once the lever is turned. I also added some particles to simulate an energy field being created before the super laser fires. And then it was time to create the main laser beam of the super laser. For that I decided to repeatedly spawn invisible armor stands in the center of the round disk. I would then let them spawn sneeze particles individually by teleporting them forwards and slightly upwards repeatedly. With a lot of these armor stands being spawned, this would create a nice, smooth laser beam. Oh, and as you can see, I also added these nice little particle balls at the origins of each of these laser beams to make the animation look more like the one from the original Star Wars films. Now that the animation was done, the Death Star was pretty much complete. But what is a Death Star without a planet for it to destroy? But luckily I had a solution for that. A few months ago I created a data pack that could generate planets without you needing to do anything. I added the data pack to this world and started generating a planet. A link to my planet generator is in the description of this video by the way. Please check it out if you're interested in stuff like that. After the planet was fully generated, the Death Star could finally show its true power. So let's flick the lever and see what will happen. Oh, look at this beautiful animation, and here it comes, the main beam. Yep, I made the laser beam spawn TNT if it hit any solid blocks. A normal planet would possibly collapse from being hit like this, but as we're on Minecraft, that's not going to happen. But it's still a good result and should be more than enough for any power-hungry intergalactic emperor. If you like this video, why not show it by clicking on the nice little thumbs up button. You can also stick around and watch some of my other content, or even subscribe if you are not already. See you soon. Bye bye, beautiful people of the internet.